is good. The devil Amen. Don't like it.
That's right.
I said the devil don't like it.
Amen.
Amen. He's trying his best to bring us down tonight. But you know what? God is able.
Yes, amen.
To lift us up.
Amen. Glory.
Amen. And no matter what he tries to do, it's not going to stop the flow of God's Spirit. Somebody
amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, give the Lord some praise. Your Bibles, I want you to go with me to Romans, the 13th chapter. Romans 13.
Amen. Amen.
Our God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Romans the 13th chapter. Amen. You have to say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And look at verse number 12. And once you have it, will you stand for the reading of the word? Romans 13 and verse 12. Amen?
Amen.
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 The night is far spent. The day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envy. But put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make not provisions for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. I think we need to read that again. Somebody
amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
The night is far spent. The day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envy, but put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make not provisions for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. Amen. You may be seated. Give the Lord some praise.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Our message tonight is walking in holiness. Mm. Walking in holiness. See, once you get saved, you've accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, and you've been baptized, then that starts a walk that's different than the way you used to walk.
Mm-hmm.
As I've said before, the things you used to do, you don't do no more.
Right?
Yeah.
And the way you talk, you don't talk no more. The way you used to talk, you don't talk no more. The way you used to act, you don't act no more. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And there's a new you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And when we change the way that we walk, act, and talk, we take on holiness before the Lord. And so our message tonight is walking in holiness, because we have so many people that have gotten saved, gotten baptized, amen, have given their life over to Jesus Christ, but they're not walking in holiness.
Amen.
They're still doing the same old things that they used to do. They're still talking the same old way that they used to talk. They're still acting the same way they used to act. And their excuse for all of this is that Jesus died for our sins.
Amen.
Jesus took all of my sins upon him on the cross. So does that mean that since he did that, that you are supposed to continue to walk in sin?
No.
Paul said, God forbid. In other words, you take on a whole new walk.
Amen.
You begin to walk like Christ. You begin to act like Christ. You begin to talk like
Amen.
Come on now.
Yes, amen. Amen.
Because you could not stand holy before God without somebody paying the price for your sin.
Glory.
Now you have someone who went to the cross, died for your sin, took all of his punishment upon himself.
Amen.
Amen. So that he could stand in front of God. Amen. The sin had been redeemed. Amen. And you could stand, amen, before Jesus, amen, in holiness.
Amen.
Amen. But Jesus, he done that, amen, so that you could look at him and walk in his ways.
Right.
Amen. He gave you an example,
yes,
of how you're to live.
Right.
Come on, church.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
How many know Jesus is our example?
Yes.
He was without sin, but yet he took on sin in order to give you a chance to
amen.
Be like him.
Amen.
So once you accepted his death, amen, and the price he paid for you, and you went down into that watery grave called baptism, and you rose again, just like he rose again. He rose to the newness of life, hallelujah. And you too rise to a new life. A new life in Christ Jesus. You're no longer the same.
No,
yeah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. And just like the Holy Ghost came upon Jesus, and he said, "This is my son, in whom I am well pleased." Amen.
Amen.
When the Holy Ghost comes upon you, amen, he says, he looks down and he says, "This is my child in whom I am well pleased." Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So then, walking in holiness, amen, Paul was talking to the Romans, which was a Gentile church. They was not Jews, amen, but there might have been some there. Amen. But he was talking to those that were outside of the Jewish race. Amen. Because he was the apostle that was sent to the Gentile.
Amen.
And Gentile is every race that other than the Jewish race. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
They're called Gentiles in the Word of God. Amen. And Paul was the apostle that Jesus sent, amen, to become the apostle to the Gentile.
Yes.
So he went and he was talking, amen, to the Romans and in the book of Romans. And he's talking about the night is far spent, the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast out the works of darkness. In other words, it's time out. The night is far spent. It's time out. Amen. How many know that the night only lasts a little while and then comes day?
Amen.
Paul is saying, the night is far spent. Amen. The day is at hand. In other words, the way you used to walk is over with. It should be over with.
Yes.
Amen. You come into the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Amen. The night is far spent and the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness. What are the works of darkness, church? All kinds of sin. All kind of things that are out there that is not pleasing in the eyesight of God. If you can, and I like to say it like this, because a lot of folks try to change up the Bible and say this is okay to do and that's okay to do. But I want you to know something, church. Amen. Anything that don't look like, act like, walk like, talk like Jesus is not Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
And it's works of darkness.
Yes.
Jesus came to bring light to this dark world. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And everything that is good and like the Lord, amen, it is light.
Praise God.
Amen. He walks in light. He don't walk in darkness. He wants you to walk in light. He don't want you to continue walking in darkness.
That's right.
Amen. The devil is of the dark.
Yes.
But when the light comes and shines upon the darkness, what happens? It becomes day. Am I not right about that? Amen. So we have to realize this is not a game. We're not playing church.
That's
right.
Amen.
So many folks are out there playing church.
Amen.
Everybody. church. I'm not saying everybody go to church and saved and walking in holiness. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that everybody out there, amen, that is called of God to be a child of God has an obligation, amen, not to walk in darkness, but to walk in holiness.
Amen.
That's what I'm saying.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. If they're not doing it, they've got to answer to Almighty God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
But it is my job to explain it to you, amen, so that if this has been happening in your life, if you've been doing this, this will give you an opportunity to have your eyes open so you can see the light and not continue to be in darkness. Are you hearing what I'm saying to you?
Amen.
Amen. Don't look at me like I'm so much, because I'm just like you. I'm trying to make it in too. Come on now.
Amen.
Amen. Every one of us have to give an account of the deeds that we do in our body to Almighty God, not to me. You got to give an account to God, because he sees everything you do.
That's true.
You know, so many people like to act holy when they're around the preacher.
Mm.
Or other saints of God. Come on, y'all know. Huh? They're holier than thou. But all the days of the week, amen, they're doing their thing.
Mm.
Amen. Am I not right?
Amen.
Huh? How many know God see every move you make?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. He's the righteous judge. Not me. He's the righteous judge. He is the one that's going to judge the good and the bad. He's the one that is going to judge us in the end. In the last day. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Let us walk honestly as in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Not in rioting and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envying. But put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what I was talking about. When you got to look like, act like, walk like, type Christ Jesus. Put on ye the Lord Jesus Christ. And make no provisions for the flesh. You know, the flesh calls for a lot of things. Glory be to God. The Holy Ghost is just talking through me. Hey, listen, church. The flesh calls for a lot of things. And if we don't turn the flesh down, we'll give the flesh what it wants.
Okay.
And I'm gonna show you, for instance, amen. I have a little trouble with my stomach. I know I shouldn't be eating cheese. But every now and then, Brother Hub wants to stop at McDonald's. And you know, I should be saying, don't put no cheese on my sandwich. But instead, I eat it because I like it. I'm making provisions for the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Because I like it.
Uh-huh.
Amen. When I know that it's not good for me.
Mm.
Are you following what I'm saying?
And
that's just a little analogy. Amen. But there's so many other things that we do. The flesh said, well, let's go get a drink. And so we find ourselves giving provisions to the flesh. Or the flesh will tell us, oh, you know you need a cigarette. Why don't you go on outside and smoke? Huh? Are you listening to me? We make provisions for the flesh. I don't care how we hurt in our bodies. I don't care how tired we are.
Amen.
I don't care how sleepy we are.
Okay.
Amen. If we ain't quite sleep yet, we gonna have that puff on that cigarette. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We make provisions for the flesh, for the things that we want to do. Amen. Amen. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
Those are just little analogies. Amen. But there's so many other things that we give the flesh what it wants.
Right.
And what I'm saying is this, is that Paul was telling the Romans, put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ and make not provisions for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof.
Mm-hmm.
And in other words, you got to learn how to say no.
That's right.
Amen. And I'm telling you, church, I'm going to practice that myself. I'm going to start saying no to some cheese. And no to some regular milk. Amen? Amen? Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
And anything else that calls me hungry. Amen. I am going to say no to the flesh. I'm making up my mind tonight. After reading this, it reinforces God's word in my life. See, so many times we hear the word of God and we think we got it. But church, I don't care how much you go to the word of God, you will always find something else in the word of God that you need to know.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Ain't that right?
Amen.
Amen. So now let's go to 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. And just stay there for a minute. What is holiness? Our subject is walking in holiness. What is holiness? It is moral and spiritual purity, righteous living, thoughts and actions, being clothed in the garment of holiness. When you make up your mind, just like you put on, I put on this robe every Saturday night to preach the word of God, amen, because of what God has told me to do, amen. When I put this robe on, amen, it's symbolic of saying that I'm putting on the robe, the garment of holiness, amen. So in your own body, you got to put on spiritually, put on a garment, the garment of holiness. In other words, cloak yourself in holiness.
Amen.
Well, if you cloak yourself in holiness, when you look at Jesus, Jesus was cloaked in holiness.
Amen.
Huh? Yeah. Amen. He was the image of holiness.
Yeah. Amen.
Am I right? So when you cloak yourself in holiness, when the devil comes to try to get you to do something that you know that don't look like, act like, walk like, talk like Jesus, amen, that's because, amen, he's trying to pierce that garment of holiness.
Amen.
But if you wrap yourself up, amen, with the garment of holiness, amen, and denounce him when he comes, amen, then you'll have on the garment of holiness, and you'll be walking in holiness.
Amen.
Amen. I said, what is holiness? It is moral and spiritual purity. Mm-hmm. You got to purify your mind.
Amen.
I said, you got to purify your mind.
Amen.
Huh? Morally and spiritually. Amen. It's righteous living. Righteous thoughts. And you know something? The devil's going to bring you all kind of negativity. He's going to bring you all kind of terrible thoughts. But you know what, church?
Amen.
You can put them down.
That's right.
Amen.
You don't have to entertain them.
That's right.
When he tells you something that you know is negative, it's up to you. See, God ain't going to take, God done already did everything he's going to do. He done told you what to do. He done told you how to walk. He done told you how to act. When them thoughts come to mind that you know are not right, amen, because that's the devil going and playing in your mind. Your mind is the playground of the devil.
Amen.
Amen. And if he can get you to entertain his thoughts, amen, he can next get you to act upon those negative thoughts.
Amen.
So what do you do when you get a negative thought, something that you know is not right with God and is trying to pierce that garment of holiness? What do you do? You put the devil to flight. You say, Satan, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus, and I command you to get out of my head, get out of my thoughts. You have no place in me.
Amen.
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 But some of us, we sit back and we entertain those thoughts.
Well.
And we think and we think and we think. And that's what's wrong with the human race. We think too much.
Ah, well.
Huh?
That's right. Amen.
We need to let God be God in our lives.
Amen.
Amen. Learn the scriptures so that when the devil come your way and begin to try to pierce your mind and come in against things that you know is right about God, learn the scriptures so you can put the devil to flight like Jesus did when he was in the wilderness. Amen. And he was going through trying times. Amen. He said, it is written.
Amen.
It is written. You know, when I first got saved, I should say born again, because I got saved when I was 13. I got baptized in water. But I did my thing after that. But at the age of 33 years old, I came back to God. And so I'm saying that at that time, amen, I began to change my ways. I began to change my walk. And I began to walk in holiness. And as the word of God came forth, as the minister preached the word of God, I began to take everything in. I began to be just like a little bird. And I, you know how a bird will receive nutrients and nourishment from its mother? Amen. I began to receive nourishment, amen, from God. Amen. From the minister as he was preaching. I began to apply every word that he said. I mean, I was just like a little bird sitting there with my mouth open, amen, and just being intent upon what he was saying, amen. And I was devouring everything that he was saying. And then I just not heard the word. I began to put the word in practice. So you got to put the word into practice. Yeah. You can't just hear the word. You got to put the word in practice. Yeah. You got to do the word. The Bible said, be a doer of the word and not a hearer only.
Amen.
See, so many of us, we hear the word. We go to church and we hear the word, but we don't listen enough. We think, even though we're sitting up in the sanctuary, we're thinking about everything else other than what the word is saying. So how can you remember and what the word is saying if you don't continue to stay in the word? Amen. And then you got to apply that word. And I can remember after the Lord had healed my body and everything, and I heard a lot of healing testimonies tonight is great, and I know all of us have got one. Amen. But I'm going to tell you something. When I was laying in the hospital, and the word of God came to me, and the devil was had me all fearful. But the Lord began to speak to my heart, and I began to reveal, he began to reveal his word to me. And he began to speak to me. And when I got out of the hospital and I was at home, amen, I was vacuuming the floor and I was feeling really good. I was cleaning the house and everything. And the devil sat on my, some of y'all done heard this story, but the devil sat on my left shoulder. I just got to tell you, I got to tell you this, because some of you maybe you don't realize how the devil sits on you. But the devil will sit on your left shoulder, and the devil said, ooh, you're looking good. You know, you're feeling good. You know, go in there and put on that little sexy outfit you got and let's go party tonight. Because you're feeling good now. And I'm steady vacuuming. And my father had given me a plaque that I used to have hanging on my wall that says, greater is he that is in me than Amen. He that is in the world. Amen. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Jesus is in me. But you know, I kept vacuuming that floor, and the devil kept speaking to me, and the Lord spoke to me on my right shoulder. And he said, do you remember the promise you made to me? Do you remember the vow that you made to me? That if I would heal your body, that you would serve me the rest of your days. And I said, yes, Lord. I made that vow in the hospital. I said, Lord, if you heal me, I'll serve you. If you just get me back up on my feet, I will serve you the rest of the days of my life. I was not a preacher at that time. I was just a child of God that had turned from my wicked way.
Amen.
Seeking God in my life.
Amen.
Amen. And I said, Lord, if you he touch my body, I'll serve you.
Thank you, Jesus.
He said, do you remember that vow? I said, yes, Lord. He said, it's up to you whether you keep that vow or not. And I looked over there on the wall and I said, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I knew right then that the devil was trying to get me back out into darkness, because that's what I used to do, church. I used to go out partying. I used to go out in my sexy clothes, amen? Not every weekend, but when I go, that's the way I go. And I used to go out and do these things. Are you listening to me? And wasn't nothing out there but hell and death. Amen? But the Lord had brought me into the light, into his marvelous light, and I had to change my ways. Amen. I made a vow unto the Lord. The word says it's better not to make a vow unto the Lord if you break it. Amen.
Amen.
It's better not to make a vow. And the Lord asked me, are you going to break that vow? And I said, no, Lord. I'm not going to break that vow. And I looked at Satan. And I'm going to tell y'all something. A lot of y'all just walk around and don't talk out loud to the devil. You pray out loud, but you don't talk out loud to the devil. Amen. You need to talk out loud to him. Amen. It's like you pray to God and you talk out loud to God. Amen. And praise and worship and asking him for what you need. You need to let the devil know where to go.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. When you recognize those thoughts are not from the Lord, you need to speak to him and tell him, Satan, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You have no place in me.
Amen.
Get thee behind me. It is written, get thee behind me.
Amen.
I will serve the Most High God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I will walk in his ways.
Yes.
I will talk in his ways.
Yes.
I will do what he tells me to do.
Hallelujah.
Church, are you listening to what I'm saying?
Amen.
I ain't talking about sometime. We got a lot of sometime in Christians. Sometimes, amen, when things ain't going right, sometimes we okay and we God. Sometimes we do what's right. Amen. I'm talking about all the time.
Amen.
I'm talking not just because you're in church. I'm talking about Monday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday also. Amen. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
Walking in holiness every day of the week. I said every day of the week.
Amen.
Amen. Because the devil is busy on his job every day of the week.
Yes.
So if you're lax in your serving of God, he's going to find a way to get in.
Yeah.
Oh, and I just got to tell y'all this. I know you may not want to hear it, but I got to tell you this. Some of y'all got some friends that don't get it. Some of you got some friends out there that don't understand what your calling God is, what your walking God is. Some of them do not understand it, and some of them are trying to get you to go back the way you used to be.
Amen.
You got to make a choice. I say you got to make a choice. Y'all can say amen if you want to. If you don't, that's okay too.
Amen.
Huh? I'm talking this now. I'm talking it because we got to walk in holiness. If you are a child of the Most High God, you got to change your ways.
Yes, amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We go along with our friends when we know our friends are wrong. We go along with it. Church, stop going along with wrongdoing.
That's right.
If it's wrong, it's wrong. Because we want to keep them as friends.
Amen.
They ain't right, ain't wanting to be right, and they're trying to bring you down with them.
Amen.
How many know they'll do it if you let them?
Uh-huh.
Amen.
I lost a whole lot of friends. When I stopped partying, I lost a whole lot of friends. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Huh? But I'll tell you what, I gained a whole lot of new ones.
Amen.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
The new friends. The ones that are trying to walk right for God.
Mm-hmm.
Those are the ones I'm talking about. Those are the friends that you need. Amen.
Amen.
Those are the ones that are trying to walk in holiness like you. And they're not going to do you no harm.
Amen.
They're not going to do you no wrong.
Yes.
They're going to try to live according to the commandments of God. They're not going to steal from you. They're not going to try to kill you. They're not going to try to do none of these things. Amen. Because they're trying to walk holy too.
Yes.
Amen.
But a lot of times we hang on to old friends. And old friends try to bring us down. And we let them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell you something. If somebody is wanting to be your true friend, they're going to respect what you're trying to do.
Oh,
even if they're not ready to go there themselves, they're going to respect your walk in God.
Amen.
If they're your true friend.
Yeah.
Am I not right about it?
You're right.
Amen. Let me go on now. So how do we walk in holiness? In 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, look at verse 33. Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners. Awake to righteousness and sin not. For some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to their shame. And that's what I was talking about friends that we have, amen, don't have the knowledge of God. They try to run around talking about they got the knowledge of God, and they try to tell you what thus saith the Lord, and they don't even understand the word of God just to get you all messed up and confused. Oh, that's not what the word means. That's not what it means. And we got to realize, amen, if they're not talking from the book, then they're talking Satan's talk. Huh?
Amen.
I'll give you an example. Amen. You talk to somebody who drinks all the time, likes to go party, and you say something to them, well, I don't go do that no more. I don't do that. And the first thing they say to you is, well, you know, the Bible says to drink a little wine for thy stomach's sake. But I was reading today, and the word of God, Paul said that to Timothy. And we're going to get to that. Paul said that to Timothy, but he said, the infirmities that you have in your body, for your recurring infirmities. He didn't say, drink it to get drunk. He said, drink a little wine for thy stomach's sake, for thy recurring infirmities. And most doctors will tell you that, you know, wine is good for you because it helps the heart, helps the blood flow because of the nutrients that's in it. Amen. They'll tell you that. Amen. But we got folk. They're not drinking it for the stomach's sake. And then the doctors will tell you, drink a little bit of wine, amen, for your stomach. Amen. It'll be good for you. Amen.
Amen.
But man, we got those that are out there going through the whole Bible. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Huh? Amen. I can't prove this, but I believe it because I believe that the devil is in fermented drinks.
Amen.
Because it'll make you drunk.
Amen. Yes, amen.
And I don't believe, amen, that God would have us to be drunk.
Amen.
Amen. And unseemly.
That's right.
Am I not right?
Amen.
And don't tell me you can drink a little bit and not get unseemly. Don't tell me you can do it because I know it. I've been there. I know how it makes you act. Sometimes, amen, you can't even drive home. Somebody say, are you hearing what I'm saying? Amen. It's act because it's then fermenting and it's turned into alcohol. And alcohol will make you drunk if you drink enough of it. I believe that Paul was talking about that wine that is not fermented. Because the Bible also tells you, even when the doctor told me that, I said, well, you know what, I don't drink wine. I said, I drink grape juice. And he said, well, it's the same thing. The only difference is one is fermented and one is not. You leave it out in the sun or wherever, it's going to ferment. Am I not right? It's going to turn to alcohol. Am I not right? Amen. But if you drink that fresh from the grape, amen, it does the same thing in the body. That's why Jesus chose it. Oh, glory be to God. We got communion tonight, church.
Yeah.
That's why Jesus chose it to represent his blood. Because it's pure.
Amen.
And undefiled. And it won't make you drunk except for drunk in the spirit. Amen. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
So these are things, you know, that people have gotten things wrong. Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners. Awake to righteousness and sin not. For some have not the knowledge of God. Some don't have the knowledge of God. They don't understand. Because the scriptures have not been laid out to them where they can understand. A lot of them don't even go to church so they can hear what the word says. You know, a lot of folks say, well, I read the word at home. Amen. I'll tell you, I used to try to read the word at home. And I would get sleepy. I was trying to read it. You need to have it explained to you, and so that you can understand what thus saith the Lord. And you need to apply it to your life. Yeah. It's not enough to just read it. Yeah. You got to also apply it.
Yes, that's right.
Somebody say amen.
That's right.
Amen. Huh? Awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to their shame. Shame on you. Amen. Amen. If you have not woke up to righteousness, it's time to wake to righteousness. Amen.
Amen.
And sin not. Amen. Am I not right about that?
Amen.
Amen. How do we walk in holiness? Go to 1 Timothy. 1 Timothy. Fourth chapter.
1 Timothy.
Fourth chapter, let's look at verse 7. Amen?
Amen.
But refuse profane and old wise fables, and exercise thyself rather unto godliness. For bodily exercise profiteth little, but godliness is profitable unto all things, having promise of the life that now is, and of that which is to come, which is to come. Look at verse 12. Let no man despise thy youth. This was Paul talking to Timothy. But be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. How should we walk in holiness? Amen. Paul says here in verse 12, let no man despise thy youth. I don't care how young you are. It don't make no difference, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation,
yes,
in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity.
Amen.
Are we not believers?
Yes. Amen.
Should we not be examples of believers?
Amen.
Should we not show forth the way that and walk in holiness the way a believer should be?
Amen.
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 Because there's others out there are watching your walk,
yes,
as we talk about so much.
Amen.
And you tell people, I'm saved. I'm walking in Jesus now. I'm not the same. I'm different than what I used to be. The places I used to go, I don't go no more.
Right.
The things I used to do, I don't do no more. Glory be to God.
Amen.
Don't let them despise you, but continue to be an example of the believer in word, in conversation. They're going to look and they're going to say, ooh, something about them is different. They're different. Well, that sure ain't the same old Margaret that I used to know.
Yes.
She different. I don't see her doing wrong doing. I don't see her doing things that she shouldn't be doing. So, you know, she says she a preacher. She must be, because I sure don't see her doing nothing wrong. See, they ain't gonna see your calling. Amen? But they gonna see your walk in Christ, because they gonna watch you. Day by day by day.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Some folks are watching you in the grocery store and you don't even know it. Me and Brother Dave talked about that. Huh? You don't even know it. They see you. They see you from a distance. They won't come over and say nothing, but they see you from a distance.
Yes.
They're watching what you do.
That's right.
Well, I know Sister Margaret says she'll preach it, but they watch me at home. Many times folks say, yeah, I saw you outside in the garden watching me from two streets over. You hear what I'm saying to you? Oh, I saw you the other day, so place. You didn't see me, but I saw you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank God I'm walking in holiness.
Yes.
Thank God I'm walking in the ways of God. Thank God I'm trying to do what is right, because
amen,
I'm professing that I'm a Christian. I'm trying to let my little light shine.
That's right.
So that men can see it. I'm not hiding my light underneath a bushel or a basket, that's the word saying. I want men to see. Amen. Yeah. Sister Margaret is what she says she is. Sister Margaret is trying her best. I'm not saying, church, that I'm all holy and that I don't never sin. I'm not saying that. I said I'm striving every day to walk like, look like, talk like, act like Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
And when I go out among the public, that's what I want them to see.
Amen.
I want them to see that I'm walking like Jesus, talking like Jesus. I want them to see the garment of holiness upon me. I want them to see the Holy Ghost riding and abiding upon my life. Are you hearing what I'm saying to you?
Amen.
Amen. People come into my home. I want them to see that the Holy Ghost is there. I don't want them to come in there and see things that's in there that should not be.
Amen.
You don't never know when somebody might visit you. And they say, ooh, I thought she was a preacher. And she got all this stuff sitting up in there. Mm. No, church. Uh-uh. Your home should look just, if you're a child of God, amen, especially if you and your spouse are children of God, your house should look just as holy as you would have the church to look. Shouldn't have all that stuff in there that don't represent God.
That's right.
And so many things we got, a lot of things we still got in our houses that we had when we was out in the world. And we still got it. And we done made a change, but we still got some of that stuff up in the house. You just giving place to the devil. Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Clean out your house. Just like you clean out this physical house, you need to clean out your homes. Amen. Throw that stuff away. It has no place in it with the child of God.
Amen.
Are you hearing what I'm saying to you?
Amen.
Come on now, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Go to 1 Timothy 5. First Timothy 5 and verse number 22. Mm-hmm. Lay hands suddenly on no man,
mm-hmm.
neither be partaker of other men's sins. Keep thyself pure. Keep thyself pure. Now I'm going to keep on reading what I was talking about earlier. Drink no longer water, but use a little wine for thy stomach's sake and thine often infirmities. Are you hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
I keep on reading that. That sounds pretty good. Some men's sins are open beforehand, going before to judgment, and some men they follow after. Likewise, also the good works of some are manifest beforehand, and they that are otherwise cannot be hid. So what am I saying from 1 Timothy 5:22? Keep thyself pure. Undefiled.
Uh-huh.
That's what it means. Undefiled. Paul told the Romans, amen, to do this. He also told the church of Corinth, amen, to walk in holiness. He also told Timothy, amen. He told Timothy also to keep himself pure. Timothy became a minister before God, amen. Paul made him a minister, amen. And as he was chosen to teach, amen, he had to keep himself pure. Paul was an apostle, and Timothy became a preacher, a minister, amen, in that church, amen. And Paul, the apostle, was telling him how he should behave himself, how he should walk pure. Amen. Because let me tell you something, church. If you give in to the people in your church, to their sinful ways, if you give in to them, you're not helping them.
Amen.
You're not helping them. You're harming them.
Yeah.
Don't let the folk in your church, amen, have somewhat or against you. Because then you can't tell them nothing. Huh?
That's right. Amen.
Until you get it straightened out, until you begin to walk in what is right, amen, you can't tell nobody how to walk. It's just like you Christians going out and telling somebody else what they should do and how they should walk, amen, and you ain't walking that way yourself.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
It's time out for playing in the church. It's time out for playing with people. If I step on your toes, I just step on your toes. Amen? Because if I don't tell you what's right, amen, and you continue, God's going to hold me accountable.
Amen.
Because while you had them in the sanctuary, while you had them at church, you did not come against their wrongdoing. And if they die in their sin, it's going to be hell. I'll be held accountable if I don't tell you. Got folks running around here talking about, amen, they so saved, they so this, they so that, amen, and living wrong. I just got to tell you, because it's the truth. The Bible tells us how we are to live. And if we don't live according to this word, we are in sin.
That's right.
You didn't come here for me to pet you up. Because I ain't going to do it. I'll tell you that right now. I'm going to tell you what's right. And it's up to you whether or not you decide to walk in holiness or not. Are you hearing me? Then it's all for me. And it's up between you and God. You can't walk straddle the fence. You can't be over here one day and over here the next day. Back and forth, back and forth. That is not pleasing in the eyesight of God.
That's right.
Make your decision today.
Amen.
Make your decision today to walk in holiness day in and day out.
Yes.
Day in and day out. Not just when you come to church on Saturday. Day in and
Amen.
Day out. Not when you just come to church on Sunday. Day in and day out. Am I not right with that?
Amen.
I said, am I not right with that?
Amen.
Because one of these days, we all are going to stand before the judgment bar. I'm not going to judge you, but God Almighty is going to judge you.
Amen.
And you're going to have to give an account for the deeds that you've done in your body. You're going to have to give an account of it. Time to get your life right.
Yes.
Not gonna play with you. It's time to get right.
Amen.
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 We wonder why we go through some of the things we go through, church. Yes, you're gonna go through some things. Yes, you are. But when you got God on your side, you can make it. You can get through. You can. He can heal your body. He can work in your life. But you make things harder on yourself when you don't walk righteously before God. When you don't do what you know is right. When you don't walk in holiness.
Amen.
We think that God is supposed to just look over our sins. Look over our sins.
Mm.
And bless us anyway. I want you to go back to the Old Testament and I want you to read. When you look up blessings. And you'll find out that blessings come to those who are obedient.
That's right.
Obedient. And cursings come to those who are not obedient.
Amen.
And then tell me, are you being blessed? Are you being cursed? Are you listening to me?
Amen.
And I ain't talking about cursed like witchcraft cursed. I'm talking about just not being able to abide in the blessings of God. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, church, we got to learn to walk in holiness. I look around at so many of the different churches today and you wonder how many, I mean, the churches are full. Some of these churches, especially on TV, they just run it over with people. And you wonder, are they really getting the truth? Or are they getting their ears tickled? The Bible said people like to run to places where they can get their ears tickled. In other words, they hear things, amen, that, you know, oh, it's soothing to them because they ain't ready to do right. Huh? There ain't no hard preaching coming down. Holiness of hell. Come on now. It's the truth. It's time for us to get. I heard Brother Mark saying, talking about the things that are going on in this world, how things are going to be coming up on people. Amen. Church, listen to me. You need the holiness of God.
Yes.
Time out for playing. Every one of us are getting older in our bodies, and our bodies are breaking down. Are you listening to me?
Uh-huh.
You need the blessings of God to stay on this road. To live a little bit longer.
Amen.
To live in peace and harmony.
Amen.
You need the blessings of God. It's time out for foolishness.
Amen.
The only ones in here, amen, that is not where we should be, amen, is these babies that's in here, these children. Everybody else in here should have on the garment of holiness if you're saved. If I ask you, are you saved? Yeah, I'm saved. Where's your garment? Where's your garment? Something that we practice daily. Not just every now and then, but daily.
Amen.
It's a change.
Yes.
Somebody that's cautious. Somebody that is close to you ought to be able to see a change in you. Ought to see a change in you. They ought to say, you know, you don't look the same. You don't act the same.
Mm-hmm.
And you ought to say, praise God.
Praise God.
Praise God. Because you don't know what I've been through. You don't know how the devil been whooping up on me. But I found a Savior. Hallelujah. And he put me on the garment of holiness. And now I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed going in. And I'm blessed coming out. And I don't care what the devil try to bring my way. I got a God. I got a Savior that's going to bring me out. Glory be to God. See, the devil's job is to bring you down to the lowest degree. But God, that's when you find God. It's when you're going through the valley.
Amen.
That's when you're so down, you're down so low that you look up and you say, he said, look up and you'll see me. Look up and you'll see me. Raise your head up and look towards me. I am your help. I am your strength. I am your God. And then when you give yourself over to him, nothing wavering. He will bless you from the top of your head to the soles of your feet.
Amen.
You have a testimony about how God brought you through that very thing that was meant to take you down. But you got a testimony to tell somebody, I once was down, I once was out, but look at me now. I'm saved, hallelujah, and I'm filled with the precious Holy Ghost.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise
God.
And it is that Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
It puts a smile on your face when you don't feel that smile.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
That lifts up that burdened out heart when your heart is heavy and your heart is hurting. It's the Holy Ghost. Amen. That'll bless you. It's the Holy Ghost when you feel you're hurting in your body. It's the Holy Ghost that'll tell you what to do to feel better. It's the Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Ghost, church.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said it's the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mm. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Devil say, I'm going to take you out. I'm going to take you out. Jesus said, by the Holy Ghost, he has no power over you.
That's right.
He has no power over you.
Yeah.
I said he has no power. Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Church.
Amen.
He has no power.
Thank you, Lord.
So what am I saying tonight? Start walking in holiness. Stop going back and forth from holiness to hell. Come on.
Amen.
Stop going back and forth. Mm-hmm. And when I'm talking about going back and forth, I'm talking about you're holy one minute and you're doing things that the devil would do. Amen. Yeah. Just because you think it's okay to do. If the word of God don't say it, and if you can't see Jesus doing it, you shouldn't be doing it, because he is the example of holiness.
Amen.
He was holy, and he was without sin. Am I not right?
Amen.
And he intends for us to strive daily to walk in holiness.
Amen.
Amen.
As he is in.
Amen.
Give the Lord praise.
Hallelujah.